Hello everybody, welcome to another Nephilim Builds. It's Pride Month and we're going to be celebrating by making various LGBTQIA+ couples in media. Today we're going to raise our adorable Jar daughter as Hualian from Heaven Official's Blessing. As always, keep in mind that these videos are about capturing the spirit of the character rather than capturing their abilities perfectly. That said, let's start with the triple ascended god of misfortune, Xie Lian. Using the standpoint array, we put the 15 to intelligence. Xie Lian has some good investigative skills. It's also literally impossible to live almost 1,000 years and come out stupid. Next, we'll put the 14 to dexterity. He was a pretty badass swordsman once. After that, we'll put the 13 to wisdom. He has Hua Chang figured out pretty quickly. That's just good insight. We'll put the 12 into constitution. Immortality has its perks. And then the 10 to charisma. He felt kind of monotone to me in the dub. Pleasantly monotone, but still monotone. Lastly, we dump strength. We don't need it. For race, I usually use Asimar for gods, but Xie Lian doesn't really do any of the things Asimar do. So we'll go with custom lineage, putting our plus 2 into intelligence and taking the magic initiate feat. We'll borrow from Artificer, getting light for a palm torch, and thorn whip and snare for Royer. Sorry if I'm butchering these names, I've not had that much practice with Chinese. We'll also take investigation and speak common and celestial. We'll make a custom background, picking acrobatics and insight, and taking carpenter's tools and cook's utensils. when your cooking can knock out multiple gods in 2 calamities, that's not food, that's poison. Moving on to class, we're going to start off as a wizard. We'll get intelligence and wisdom saving throws, pick arcana and history, and be proficient with wizard weapons. At level 1, we'll get arcane recovery and 3 cantrips. We kind of already have the only attack cantrip we need, so we'll take friends and mending to fill the slot, and message for a small spiritual communication array. We'll also prepare for our spells, taking mage armor and shield for AC, and magic missile. Funny, the wiki doesn't mention energy bolts, but that's what he uses in episode 3. Even if it's once, it still counts. We'll also take Thunder Wave for an energy pulse, which I have been assured wasn't actually a wind burst, because Xie Lian is not the Windmaster. What, does she have sole legal rights over the use of wind magic? We're now going to multiclass to Monk, getting simple weapons and short swords. At level 1 we get Martial Arts and Unarmored Defense, and at level 2 we'll get Ki and Unarmored Movement. At level 3 we get Deflect Missiles, Ki Field Attack, and our Monastic Tradition. We're going to take the Way of the Kensei, picking Long Swords for a Kensei weapon. The ranged option won't matter. I don't care if he uses a sword to fight anymore or not, that fight against the demon was badass. We'll also get Agile Parry, Kensei Shot, and Calligrapher's Supplies. At level 4 we'll get Slow Fall because of his fall damage, and round off our Intelligence and Wisdom. This will also let us prepare Detect Magic. At level 5 we'll get Extra Attack and Stunning Strike. At level 6, we get Keen Power Strikes, Magical Kensei Weapons, and Death Strike. We won't need another Kensei Weapon unless you want to use a whip for Ruye. At level 7, we'll get Evasion and Stillness of Mind, and at level 8, we'll take the Tough Feat. Back to Wizard, at level 2, we'll get our Arcane Tradition. We're gonna go with Blade Singing for Blade Song, Performance, and Light Armor. We'll also take Sleep. Oh look, another one that's not listed in the wiki. At level 3, we'll take Dust Devil. Call it Wind, call it Energy, I don't care. He makes a Twister in episode 3. Twice. In a row. Oh, and another one not listed, starting to think these are Donghua only. At level 4, we'll cap our intelligence and take Prestidigitation. We'll also take Earthbind and Hold Person for more uses for Royer. At level 5, we'll get Sending for another use of the Spiritual Communication Array. At level 6, we'll get the Special Extra Attack and Magic Circle. Add that to the list. At level 7, we'll take Augury. Spoiler, it's always gonna come up woe. At level 8, we'll raise our Dexterity and take Invisibility. This one actually was listed. So is the Command Talisman, which we'll take at level 9 as Suggestion. At level 10, we'll get Song of Defense and take True Strike and Teleportation Circle. At level 11, we'll take Flesh to Stone. This is another spell that was listed in the wiki, and I've been assured by a friend that he can do this, though it seems out of character. Hey wiki writer, maybe include who is known to cast each spell? At level 12, we'll raise Dexterity again and take Silence. Now that we're level 20, we finally have our modifiers. For inventory, we'll take a Longsword for Function and a Component Pouch. Our AC with Mage Armor is 17, our movement speed is 45, and our average HP is 150 with 8d8 and 12d6 hit dice. And with that, we are done. Of course, where would the Crown Prince be without his greatest worshipper? Using Point Buy will make Charisma 15. This man goes from cutie to daddy at the drop of a hat.
Wait, what's that? 19? What? Have you seen this man?
Okay, so apparently he has JoJo syndrome. Next we'll make Dexterity and Constitution 14. He's a badass fighter, and ghosts are hard to kill. We'll make Strength and Intelligence 10, we don't particularly need either, and then dump Wisdom. He has some serious insecurities. For Race, we're going to go with Reborn, putting our increases into Charisma and Dexterity. We'll take Deception and Intimidation for skills, and get Deathless Nature, Knowledge from Past Life, and Speak Common and Abyssal. We'll make a custom background picking perception and religion and taking painter supplies and carpenter's tools. Moving on to class, we're going to start off as a fighter. We get strength and constitution saving throws, pick athletics and acrobatics for skills, and be proficient with all weapons, armor, and shields. At level 1, we get second wind in our fighting style, picking dueling. We're now going to multiclass as divine soul sorcerer, getting favored by the gods and divine magic at level 1, and picking neutrality for affinity for protection from evil and good. We'll start with 4 cantrips, taking infestation, mage hand, and dancing light for a bunch of butterflies. We'll also take prestidigitation, harmless sensory effect plus make something dirty equals tiny blood rain cloud. Sorry, but that's the closest I'm gonna get. I'll also start with 2 spells, taking mage armor and shield for AC. At level 2, we'll get font of magic and feather fall because what is fall damage? At level 3, we'll get meta magic, taking subtle spell and quicken spell. We'll also take spiritual weapon for ME. Am I saying that right? At level 4, we'll take the Eldritch Adept feat, taking mask of many faces to cast disguise self at will. We'll also get Mind Sliver to pop snakes with and Healing Word for some healing butterflies. I'd love to have taken Healing Spirit for this since a friend of mine has flavored it as butterflies before, but sadly neither Sorcerer nor Cleric get it. At level 5 we'll get Magical Guidance and take Levitate to pick people up with our butterflies. At level 6 we'll get Empowered Healing and take Spirit Guardians. Does he use his butterflies like this? I don't know! Between Heaven Official's Blessing and Modao Zushi, I'm starting to think that manhwa wiki writers are somehow worse than manga wiki writers. That said, whoever wrote this wiki must have been a major Hua Chong fan because I actually had plenty to work with for him. At level 7 we'll take Death Ward and at level 8 we'll take the Tough Feet. Let's get the spell here. At level 9 we'll take Insect Plague and Telekinesis for stronger butterflies. Back to Fighter, at level 2 we'll get Action Surge and at level 3 we'll get our Martial Archetype, taking Champion for improved critical. At level 4 we'll raise our Charisma, at level 5 we'll get extra attack, and at level 6 we'll cap our Charisma. At level 7 we'll get Remarkable Athlete and at level 8 we'll raise our Dexterity. At level 9 we'll get Indomitable, at level 10 we'll get a second Fighting Style. We'll go with Interception to protect Xie Lian. At level 11 we'll get another extra attack. Now that we're level 20, we finally have our modifiers. For inventory, we'll take a scimitar for Ming when he's not flying around. We'll also take an amulet for spellcasting focus and call it the earring he got from Xie Lian. Our AC with mage armor is 17, our rune speed is 30, and our average HP is 186 with 96 and 11d10 hit dice. And with that, we are done. Now what can these builds do? To start, both of them are solid melee fighters. Xie Lian is more defensive with higher base AC, Blade Song, and Song of Defense. Meanwhile, Hua Chong is more offensive with more attacks, Spiritual Weapon, and Spirit Guardians. The real synergy though comes from combining Xie Lian's battlefield control with Hua Chong's high damage AoEs. Earthbind, Hold Person, and Sleep give us ways to keep enemies in a single spot, while Spirit Guardians and Insect Plague wreaks havoc on them. For weaknesses, a low strength means Xie Lian is in trouble if General Millstone goes in for a hug. Plus, a low HP pool means he'll quickly be put into Power Word kill range if he runs out of slots for a Song of Defense. Hua Chong is of course susceptible to wisdom saves and an uncapped dexterity hurts us both offensively and defensively. I thought about taking a level of Hexblade to use Charisma for our attacks, but decided to go with the second extra attack instead. Weaknesses aside, these two work well together both in combat and in love, even if they don't have Heaven's official blessing. Thank you everybody so much for watching. If you'd like to support my channel, there's a link to my Patreon down in the description. $1 a month gives you 2-day early access to my videos, a chance to vote for future characters, and access to all of my homebrew content. I'll admit, I didn't count the number of Fridays I'd be getting this month. This is going to be my last Pride build for this year, but it looks like I have room for one more. Ah, fuck it, the next character I was gonna do has a girlfriend. Let me know what you thought of this video down in the comments, and I'll see you all next week when I make Violin from League of Legends and Arcane.